The Tao of Self-Confidence, Episode 535.
Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. Visit our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.
Well, hello, friend. Welcome to the Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. I'm your host today, Sheena Yap Chan, and today I have an amazing lady on the show today. She's a Chinese-born American who got exported out of the country, and she'll probably elaborate more about that. And I'm really excited to have her on and share her story with us today on self-confidence. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce you to Bunny Yan. Bunny, how are you today? Maybe you can fill in a little bit more about yourself to our listeners.
Hi, everybody. I feel great. It's a beautiful day outside today, sunny. Elaborate, yeah. So I am a Chinese-born American who left when I was 12 and raised in New Jersey. And now I currently work and live in New York.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And Bunny, what would be your favorite self-confidence quote?
Self-confidence quote? Quote, I don't really have one, a quote from anybody. For me, it's really when, especially come to, I guess, for me, Chinese culture, everybody have that like tendency to overprove themselves because how we were raised. So for me, it was early on, like in my mid-20s, that I tell myself, no, I need to be more confident with me and things I do instead of continue to prove to please somebody.
Thanks for sharing that. And in your own words, how do you define self-confidence?
It's when you're truly happy with what you're doing. Doesn't matter if you fuck up or succeed very well. Actually recognize it as what it is. If it's something that's a mistake or didn't come out the way you wanted to, you're still recognize the value in what you learned and the journey of it all.
Thanks for sharing that. And I love how you mentioned that because I think no matter what happens, we can always learn something from it, good or bad. And I always believe something good can always come out of every situation that we encounter. So thanks for sharing that definition. And Bunny, what was your life like before your discovery of self-confidence?
It really isn't like a cutoff point, right? So it's more transition. So I did have a tendency to always try to, I guess, overachieve. Prove myself and always aim for higher and higher because, like I said, growing up, it's always okay if you got an A on a test, why not A plus? So, little by little, to the point that I'm not feeling fulfilled anymore, even when I am getting awards, good grades, getting praise. And I think little by little, I realized that I am not seeing the value in me. So there wasn't really a turning point. It's actually a journey how to correct that. Like I trying to correct my own behavior and it did work. It's like it might not work for everybody, but I started by writing down all my achievements or even the littlest thing. Like, you know, my friend was happy at my joke today in a little notebook. I did that for a year and literally trained that behavior out of myself to always doubting and always, oh, the whole overachiever thing, right? So that really take a big toll on how I feel about myself and on the confidence side.
Thanks for sharing that. And, you know, I think that's something we all go through, you know, feeling like we're never enough. We always have to keep on doing more. Like you mentioned, you know, it's like you got an A on your test. Why not an A plus? Like it's never enough. And it's frustrating sometimes. But was there a moment in your life when you realized like you can just be yourself, like your true self? I mean, was there like an aha moment in your life?
I actually got laid off. I don't remember which year was it. And, you know, of course, I feel bad for a little. But then I took a moment to realize, you know what? I have done A, B, C, D, E, right? I did the best I could. I don't have a moment in there that I go like, you know what? I kind of just wasted time. I literally learned even from the days that I just trying to be lazy and not doing anything. Like, you have takeaways. So I wasn't feeling bad about myself. I think that's a big aha moment. It's when you're down and you still can realize that, you know what? It happened. Dust it off, get up, you know, I mean, not saying like, oh, you know, of course, like it will happen regardless, but recognize what it is and take the learning and keep forward kind of deal. So yeah, that was my aha moment when I was actually down and wasn't being mad about myself and saying what else I can do or regrets. And I like that. Like, whatever I do, I don't have regrets. You can always do things different, but it is all the things that you did that makes you who you are and get you to where you are now. There's absolutely no point in regretting them.
Thanks for sharing that. And I love how you mentioned, you know, even though it was like a low point in your life, you know, you saw, you know, what good can come out of it. And sometimes when we're down, there's no other way than going up, right? So, I mean, we have to just sometimes get back up and keep moving. I mean, yeah, well, it'll suck, right? Sometimes we feel like, I can't believe this happened to me. You know, why did I get laid off? And you know, that's fine to feel that way because we're human. But, you know, there comes a point in our life where like, okay, this happened to me. Maybe, you know, like they say, when one door closes, another one opens, right? And because of that realization that you've learned, what's your life been like now?
So I am CEO of my own startup, The Squirrelz. So we're really focusing on making the world a better place, in lack of better words, but profitable. So for me, it's that balance. And in Chinese culture, it's a lot about balance. And I really do see that in all different aspects. And being balanced about yourself within, it's pretty much a reflection of what you do. So able to slow down sometimes and just look at the bigger picture and knowing which part to drop, which part to continue. We're always juggling so many balls, right? And to the point that we feel overwhelmed and there's so many things and we feel like, no, we have to do all of these. You don't have to do any of it. There's a lot of it we trade off because we are insecure, afraid, either being judged or really being your true self, or just realizing certain aspects is no longer working anymore and the fear of dropping that because we invested time, right? So all of that and continue learning is how I've been, I guess, living. And of course, like, there's going to be new lessons and new way of looking at things. If we chat again in like a year, there probably will be tweaks. But it's more like add-on to what you have realized about yourself.
Thanks for sharing that. And Bunny, to the woman who's listening to your episode, she may be in her own journey to self-confidence. What would be that one tip you would give to her?
Talk to people, especially the more, I guess, strong ones. The one are having high pressure jobs, management position. We tend to, especially females and Asian, we tend to trying to have that, again, the proving thing, right? Doesn't matter to your parents or to your superior. And we stop talking to people because we feel like if we show any kind of a weakness or something that we couldn't do, somehow we failed. And that alone, and realizing that you could talk to people about that and find the best friend, even people in the industry who can just understand and just chat and open that up. And that's the real strength coming through. So be vulnerable. And that's something actually I learned recently, like within the last 6 months. Because for the longest, being the only child and being a single mom family, it's that whole, you have to hold up everything. You can't cry, right? Like being a boy. Yeah, little by little, I learned like there's stuff I could open up and it's fine. It doesn't show weaknesses. And it actually lets you realize some of the stuff that you pretty much may be lying to yourself as well. And able to hear yourself speak about it and realizing that it's not only you. It literally is everybody. So yeah, that is quite an interesting journey that I've been taking recently that I would love to share. So yeah, talk to each other.
Thanks for sharing that. And Bunny, if our listeners wanted to get to know a little bit more about you and what you do, is there any links or social media profiles we can connect with?
Yes, so you can search me, Bunny Yan. Yan is Y-A-N. Bunny is like, you know, bunny rabbit. On Google, you'll get to see my company website, The Squirrelz. It's a lot of rodents, but email me there. It's fine. The Squirrelz with a Z at the end, but had to have the in front of it. I'm on Facebook. I'm on Instagram. Yeah, pretty much these days you can reach me anywhere. I'm pretty sure you have a link on your podcast on the bottom too, right? So yeah, if anybody want to chat and tell me about what happened to you and how you overcome, I'm just curious overall.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And to our listeners, if you want to connect with Bunny, you can also head on over to the TalvSelfConfidence.com and search for Bunny's name. Her show notes will pop up along with everything else that we talked about. And I really just want to thank Bunny today for taking the time to share her story and tips with us on self-confidence. So thank you so much, Bunny.
No problem. And by the way, if any of you are foodies and want to go for hot pots or anything spicy, call on me because I love to eat.
Awesome. And to our listeners, be on the lookout for another new episode of Another Amazing Woman's Journey to Self-Confidence, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.
Bye.
Thank you for tuning in to another amazing episode of The Tao of Self-Confidence. Want to learn how you can use podcasting to market your business? Download your free report by visiting our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.